Let me ask you something. Do you like nut? There is one base component to all life in the universe. Nut. And by that, I mean Nutella. As of recently, my channel's mostly been focused on Nutella-based content, and you know what? I'm deciding to embrace it. I'm gonna give you a brief rundown on the entire history of the art form, the, craft that is Nutella. So what is nut? Well, basically, you can put it on whatever you want, and it tastes good. Now, to get a full understanding of the history of Nutella, we need to travel back to Italy. Under Mussolini. Well, technically, it was made, like, a year after he died, but I think it's hilarious to imagine that Mussolini might have had some part in creating Nutella. No, but in reality, it was some random chocolate maker who, decided to put chocolate into a loaf. You heard that right. Nutella originally came in a loaf. Now, this is called the Ghianduat.
Gianduio.
John Dujon. It's this thing. It's a sweet paste that you can spread on pretty much anything, named after a local carnival character right here on the official Nutella website. Created in 1946, this is effectively the first rendition of Nutella. Very monumental, is that a word? Now let's fast forward a couple years. It's the 50s now, 1951. We have Super Crema. It's not a porn star. It's what we might be a lot more accustomed to with our nut. They took the original Ghianduat paste and transformed it into a new creamy product that was easier to spread, called Super Crema. Now this was sort of like the pre-alpha version of Nutella. You can look at it as like a sort of the inspiration, like a early concept art. And then, in 1964 AD, Nutella is born. Nut was created. The new recipe improved. The first ever jar of new hazelnut and cocoa cream was created, a name synonymous with spread and smile, nut. Anyway, fast forward like 12 months and you get the iconic jar. This is the modern packaging that we still see to this day, and I think it's truly incredible that almost half a century later, probably more than that actually once I'm doing the math, nut still comes in the same containers. Ooh, 1966, nut arrives in France with great success. Nut invaded France and they loved it. It came in these like milk carton type things. All right, we're fast forwarding to 1978. Almost the 80s, nut has no borders. The success of nut, the reach of their nut had no borders. It reached Australia and Europe and Lithgow, all sorts of interesting places. What is Lithgow? Now at this point, it was really picking up steam. It was starting to get more popular. It was growing as a brand and a company. And then in 1996, 30 years of optimism for Nut. Generation Nut was held, and then all the artists of Nut enjoyers all came, such as D. Couflé, Paco Rabanne, and Wolinski, some notable Nut enjoying musicians. Anyway, this was called the Le Grand Show, and it was sponsored by Nutella. I'm not sure what exactly those two have to do with each other, but take my word for it, it was important. This is all off the website, official stuff here, folks. All right, we're fast forwarding to 2005, turn of the century. Huge stuff. Nut gets in the world records. Nut makes its way onto the Guinness Book of World Records because 27,854 people all gathered in Glurkturn and participated in the largest nut-eating gathering. Second, of course, only to your mom last night. And then, 2007, World Nut Day. A time for all the nut enjoyers to rejoice. And apparently this is a festival that happens every year, February 5th, 2011. Share your passion of the nut. Over 10 million people have followed Nut on Facebook. And they have many things to say about it, such as thanks, gracias, dank. Nut was very appreciative. Anyway, fast forward to 2017, May 31st. Nut opened its first restaurant, the Nut Bar, the Nut Emporium, where all nut fans can enjoy a unique experience by choosing delicious recipes from a wide menu. Now, that doesn't really make much sense to me because there's just one product. They're selling nut.